really fucking weird voice. That's very, very difficult to work with. And this song is actually, there's a whole other context to it, which is just that it's a nice story. It's a sad story, but... So let's not ruin the song. Please keep your laughter to yourself, but notice while I sing how much I'm just trying to keep my fucking weird fucking nasally voice in check. Or how about this? I just won't keep it in check. Sounds like in my head. That's what I actually hear in my head is my voice sounds like. It sounds fucking awesome. Like when I'm like writing, when I'm like conceptualizing the music, my voice is like Frank Sinatra, basically. And then when I go to record it, it's Kermit the Frog. And I'm not even joking. I know that seems like an embellishment, but that's. And so you just learn to, you just come to accept the Kermit inside of you. It's not easy being green, you guys. Never had much family, never had too many friends. And you can't wander out through. And obviously I took you for granted. So I gotta write this little love song for you. I'll sing about those Denver mornings you wake up bawling about some long lost kid. Your maternal instincts were kicking in as the sun dazzled bright. I said, well, what kind of man would I be? So you bought her a collar and called her family. Selfish, your writers are idiots. I'm afraid I'm as bad as Eric is. Yeah, I keep forgetting to censor the truth. Well, come on, I mean, that's why I'm writing the goddamn love song for you, right? Country in a U-Haul. On the hunt for our new home. Higher town, Eagle Rock. We found a house with a big backyard. So we picked up yet another mud. Sipping coffee on the porch while the dogs wrestle on the lawn. I'm sorry, I had my doubts. We're a family of strays, together we've been found. We're a family of strays, but together we've been found. Oh. excellent storytellers, but I'll let you in on another little secret that I've never told anybody before, but it's something I share. I have some friends over here who know about these two dogs that I had, these two sweet dogs that I lived with for a while. But that song is kind of about them, and that ending, the oh, it's actually howling. Think about it next time you hear it. That's just like, it's like that's us as a dog pack howling. I don't know. Next time, just know that that's what I'm doing, is I'm howling.